Hey guys, this is Eddie the Magic Monk. Welcome to another technology tutorial. Today I want to introduce you guys to Microsoft DOS commands. Now you might be asking, well, what are they and do I need them? Well, back in the old days before Microsoft Windows, there was an operating system called Microsoft DOS, and basically, it was just Windows without any sort of graphical user interface. So you couldn't drag and drop anything, and basically everything had to be typed in on the keyboard. So for example, if you wanted to go to a certain folder, you have to type that in. If you had to run a program, you have to type in the file name of the program and so on. So you might ask, well, why do we need to learn that now that we have Windows, and for those Apple users, now that we have Mac OS where everything's done with the mouse, why do we need to go back to Microsoft DOS commands? And that's because when you encounter a problem, for example, let's say your hard drive space has run out, or your computer is infected with a virus and all those sorts of problems, it's a lot easier to fix when you have some Microsoft DOS knowledge. So how do we get into command prompt? That's the first thing we'll go through. So basically all you do is you right click on the bottom left hand corner of your Windows 8 and you click command prompt admin. So you click that, and then do you want to allow this program? Click yes, and then you are in Microsoft DOS, which is run under administrator mode, command prompt. Okay, so here is where pretty much you can do everything like you did in Microsoft DOS back in 1993 or 4 or whatever. Okay, so another thing you want to know is if you weren't in Windows 8, if you were in Windows 7, you can also go into it through clicking the start button and then clicking run, and then type in CMD and then press OK, and you can also get into command prompt that way. Just make sure that when you go into it that it says administrator access at the top of the title bar, because you kind of need administrator access if you want to do anything important. Okay, so now the first thing we'll do is learn how to change folders. And you can see that right now we're inside the Windows folder and we're inside the System32 folder within the Windows folder. So normally if you wanted to get into this folder, you'd go to Windows Explorer, go to C drive, Windows, and then you would go to System32. You'd go into it that way, right? But here in DOS, this means that we're already inside that folder. So if you want to get out of that folder, if you want to go back up one level, you would type CD dot dot. And this represents that we just got out of the System32 folder. And if you type CD dot dot again, you would then go back up one more level and now you're in the root folder. So what if you want to get inside the Windows folder again? You would type CD space Windows. By the way, CD stands for change directory. And then if you want to get into the System32 folder, you would type CD space System32. So now this will get you out of the folder and this will get you in the folder. Okay, the next thing you guys need to know is what if I want to jump back up two or three folders? I'm not going to type CD dot dot CD dot dot. Instead of typing it twice, I can just type in cd/, and that will get me out a lot quicker. Similarly, if I want to go inside system32, instead of typing two cd commands, I can just type cd:\windows/system32, and I can get inside that folder really quickly. Okay, so what can you do once you're inside the folder? Well, you can type dir, which lists all the files in that folder or in that directory. Now you can see that it lists all of it in one column, and if you want to list the files sideways, you can type dir/w, and that will list the files, it used to anyway list them all horizontally, but now it doesn't. Now it just lists them without any file info. So anyway, or you can also type in dir/s, and what that does is not only does it list all the files in the system32 directory, it'll also list any files in any folders within the system32 folder. So all the files in the subfolders. So if you type that, you can see that a lot more files come up, and it has listed all the files within the subfolders of system32. And you notice that at the end of it, it tells you how many files there it's been listed, how many folders there are, and how big the files are in total, and how much space we have left. Right, so we have 35 gigabytes left. Okay, so this concludes our first tutorial. See you guys next time.